of life for many women, the youthful shape and firmness you'd like to see in the mirror doesn't always stick with us as we go through life's changes. Still, as Dr. Tom Howard with the Sioux Falls Center for Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery shows us, you don't have to say goodbye to those trendy clothes and swimsuit styles for good. Thanks so much for joining us today, Dr. Tom Howard.
Thank you.
We are talking about breast lifts. So what is this procedure and how does it differ from a breast augmentation?
Well, breast augmentation, where we do a small incision, typically underneath the breast, and put an implant to increase the size of the breast and sometimes a little bit of the shape. A breast lift varies in that it's a much larger incision, but with that incision, we're able to redistribute the breast tissue, lifting it up on the chest wall and putting the nipple in a more desirable and aesthetic location.
So people interested in a breast lift are happy with their size, just not how they're looking?
Right. So a good candidate for a breast lift surgery would be someone who loves how they look and feel when they're in a bra, but when they take their bra off and their nipples pointing to the floor, or they're dissatisfied with drooping of the breast tissue, then a breast lift surgery would be directed towards them and their concerns.
Who is a suitable candidate for a breast lift?
So anyone who is just dissatisfied with how their breasts are drooping, with the position of their nipple, and wanting to get more youthful aesthetics and proportions to their breast, but maybe not so interested in getting larger breasts like via a breast augmentation.
Is there any reason why someone who would want a breast lift wouldn't be able to have one?
There are several contraindications to breast lifts. Certainly anyone that's not willing to put up with the scarring from the larger incisions or unwilling to go through some of the risks and the complications of the surgery, we might talk them into a different type of procedure or no procedure at all.
Are there any options for women who not only want to do this breast lift but also increase a loss of size or volume?
Absolutely. In fact, we can combine the augmentation or placing an implant with a breast lift or a mastopexy. So an augmentation mastopexy is a surgery where we lift the breast into a more desirable location and then we fill the breast, giving it better shape, volume, and projection with an implant.
Would that require two different surgeries or how does that work?
Oftentimes it does not require two surgeries. We can do both of these procedures at the same time. So your downtime and facility fees and everything get applied to one surgery, breast enhancement in one setting instead of multiple surgeries over several weeks to months.
And what is the recovery like for that?
Typically, we're looking at about a week or two off of work, depending on what you do. If you have a very strenuous job, you're probably going to want closer to 2 weeks, but most people that have desk jobs can be back in a week or so. And then strenuous activities, we can start those up in a month. So for the first month, you're going to be doing light tasks and household duties. After a month, you can start to advance your more strenuous activity. And I tell my patients at 2 months, if everything feels fine, then you can go ahead and do whatever you would like.
And that's for if you do the breast lift and the enhancing in size?
Yeah, pretty much.
Is it the same for breast lift as well?
Pretty much the same, yeah. You might recover a little bit quicker without the augmentation. But yeah, that's just a good rule of thumb for recovery in general is to give yourself time to heal. You've invested a lot of time and your own money into the procedure, so we want you to have a good outcome and not to risk any of your complications or setbacks.
How do you help the woman feel confident in doing this procedure?
Well, I think just illustrating to them how it's done, educating them what all goes into the decision making, and then if they're a wonderful candidate for this surgery and there aren't any huge worrisome risks that would be involved, I think just telling them, hey, we think you're a great candidate. I think you're going to have a very good result and you're going to be happy with this decision once you've been allowed to recover from your surgery.
Do you see a lot more people going toward the option for a breast lift rather than augmentation?
We probably do more augmentations here. They're still slightly more popular, not only in South Dakota, but across the country. Breast lift surgeries are typically reserved for women later on in life, maybe not early in their 20s, but in their, after they had their children and their breasts have changed with pregnancy or weight loss and time, then that breast lift, plus or minus an implant, can really provide a great enhancement procedure for them going forward.
You said after having kids and stuff, we all know about that. So if someone were to get a breast augmentation before having kids and then after kids want to do that, can you get a breast lift later after that, even if you've already had an augmentation done?
Absolutely. You can just simply lift the breast tissue onto an existing implant, or if you want to change the size or shape of your breast, you can exchange implants and do a breast lift with an augmentation again.
Will insurance cover any of these procedures?
Insurance does not cover breast augmentation surgery or breast lifts. It will cover breast reductions, which is a similar procedure but done for very different reasons.
And if there's one thing you want women to know about this, about breast lifts, what would that be?
Well, I think it's something that is being done more than you think. There's women out there that are going through the breast lift procedure, maybe not telling their friends. It's can be a very private thing. So don't feel like other women aren't interested in it and also doing it, and honestly, sometimes very thrilled in their results, very happy with their decisions.
All right, thank you very much, Dr. Tom Howard. Looking to boost how you look and feel about your appearance? Then be sure and give Dr. Howard a call to schedule a consultation. Just give them a call or go online. You can send an email direct through Sioux Falls Plastic Surgery.